In this module, we'll introduce the Tabular Modeling Definition Language, or TMDL. But in order to do that, we have to explain something else first. Now let's take a look at an example. We're looking at a report, a very simple report, with our model from some space parts data, space parts being the training data set that you can use for all of our trainings on Tabular Editor Learn for free. And all of this is in one Power BI desktop file. Now, if I wanted to save this file, I could save it as, for example, a Power BI desktop file or PBIX. This is a binary format that I cannot open in any other way than using Power BI desktop, at least none that are supported. So if I wanted to view the contents of that file, I wanted to delete a table or a measure, make changes with code programmatically, or do anything else more sophisticated or complicated, I can't. I can't even see what changed in the model when I save it, for example, to version control. So I have no visibility on the contents of this file, not my data, but the metadata, the structure of my model and my report. Now, this is very different when I'm using the Power BI projects format, or PBIP. This splits up my file into multiple files, a project. As you can see, we have a PBIP file here, but we also have a folder for my report and a folder for my model. Now, inside of these folders are all of the metadata, the definitions. In here, I have DAX queries and I have the TMDL scripts, which we are, of course, going to talk about. And in the report, I also have my report metadata. Now, why would I do this? Why would this be interesting? Well, for many reasons. I can now view these contents inside of here. I can open them and change them. For example, I can do find and replace. I can copy things like copying visuals between reports. I can copy model objects. I can do all kinds of things. I can now have visibility on the changes that are happening when I save my report or my model to version control, so I can see that someone else added a new measure or that they changed something in a DAX expression. There's all these possibilities that either enhance my productivity or enable new ways of working that were not possible before. The PBIX format is perfectly fine if this works for you and you're able to do everything that you need. However, the PBIP format enables a lot of new scenarios, new possibilities, and new productivity. Now, do you need the PBI format to do TMDL scripting? No, you do not. But let me explain why I'm talking about this. Normally, when you save a PBIP file, the model metadata is saved as this BIM file. A BIM file, as you can see, is a JSON file, so it has these squiggly brackets and nested structure where we have our model properties and all this technical information, but it's quite hard to read. We have all these quotations and escaped characters. It's just not very easy to work with or read. Now, instead of this BIM format, we could actually opt into using a TMDL or Tabular Model Definition Language format. So now compare, here we're looking at the information for our customer table. So as you can see, and this information in TMDL is much easier to read, not just because it's highlighted, because we're using an official extension from Microsoft in VS Code that supports that, but also because it's just more structured, more organized. We can see the DAX, we can read everything. It's a very clear syntax for our model metadata. And as you can see, it's called customers.tmdl. The BIM contains everything for our entire model. TMDL serializes our metadata, and what that means is that it splits it up into multiple files. It then declares what the object type is, like in this case, table, the object name, its properties, and we can also then see other things like expressions and so on and so forth. So there is a very consistent and structured syntax that is very pragmatic for us to read and use. Now, is this the same as a TMDL script? No. This is just our model metadata. If I go back to our PBIP or Power BI project, I can, and remember, this is just the Power BI report and model that I saved, I can actually go in this semantic model folder, definition, and I can see the definition or the metadata for all of my tables and all of the stuff in my model. So the TMDL format makes it much easier when I want to open something and view something and make changes. I can even work in this way. So I can build a model by using code. I can just write the code. I can edit this here in Visual Studio Code, and then I can save it. And so long as it's valid TMDL, it will work, and we will see those changes represented in Power BI Desktop when we open it for the next time. Now, you might be seeing this and thinking, well, this is all very technical. Why would I be interested in this? I don't want to write my model in code. I want to work in Power BI Desktop. Well, the reason I'm explaining this is because this same syntax is used in the TMDL script. But the difference is that a script is functional. It's doing something. Whereas this TMDL file that we're looking at and the TMDL metadata, it is just the definition of your semantic model. It's just serialized metadata. So even though a TMDL script and the TMDL files from your model look very similar, they are very different. And it's important to not get them confused. You also don't need to have this metadata option enabled to use TMDL scripts. So to summarize, Power BI projects are a new format that allows you to split your PBIX file up into multiple files so that you can open and view the contents. You can change those contents, which allows you to make changes without opening up Power BI Desktop, or make automatic changes with code. TMDL is a new format for model metadata that is easier to read and work with, and it's the foundation for everything that comes after, including TMDL scripts. But it is different from TMDL scripts, and you do not need to use PBIP or the TMDL metadata format to use TMDL scripts in Power BI Desktop. In the next module, we'll introduce TMDL scripts and show you some examples and also explain their syntax. So I'll see you there.